Aloha, it's Robert Stelic with Blue Planet Surf. I wanted to go over a couple terms from aeronautics, really, but it's the angle of attack versus the angle of incidence. Really, the angle of incidence is kind of the built-in angle of the foil. So if you imagine a straight line running through the fuselage, and then a line running through the foil from the tip to the tip here. So usually on the front wing is between 1 and 3 degrees on most foils. And then the tail wing has a opposite angle. So by pulling down on the back, it kind of creates lift. And when you're riding, it kind of automatically keeps going. The back tail wing is usually also between 1 and 3 degrees relative to the fuselage. So that's the angle of incidence. If the board is flat, you want that angle of incidence to be the same way. You don't want it to be way off. Like sometimes if you have a lot of rocker in the tail of your board, your mast can be kind of tilted backwards, which means you have less angle of incidence. So that means it might be harder to take off. Or if it's kind of angled forward too much, then that increases your angle of incidence. And then that way the foil will lift faster, but it might also be harder to control because you have to push the nose down more to kind of make up for that when you're riding. When you're riding, what really matters is the angle of attack. So, and that's the relative angle to the water flow. So once there's water flowing over the foil, that's the angle of attack. So the steeper the angle of attack is on the water, the more lift it's going to create. And the slower you're going, basically the more you need to increase the angle of attack on the same size foil to keep it going. And then as you're going faster, you kind of push the nose down to kind of decrease the angle of attack. If it's not very steep, you can have the board kind of flat. If the wave's really steep, you have to kind of follow the angle of the wave. So if you're on a steep wave, your board has to be kind of parallel to the surface of the water to keep that angle from becoming too big. Otherwise, the angle of attack, if you have the board like this and the waves like this, is going to be a really steep angle of attack relative to the foil, and you're just going to shoot out of the water and breach. That's kind of one of the things that's tricky about foiling, especially for surfers, because instead of being two-dimensional, where you're on the water surface and just going left and right, on the foil, it adds that whole dimension of up and down. So you got the height of the foil flying up and down and the left and right turning. It's like basically adding a third dimension to the surfing, and that can be kind of hard to figure out for beginners. The real simply put is the angle of incidence is the static angle, the way it's designed. Like the fuselage is straight, then you got the angle of the front wing and the angle of the back wing and the 90 degrees mast and then the shape of the board. But once you get in the water, angle of attack is the angle of the water flow to the foil. So if you're taking off on a steep wave, your foil has to be follow the contour of the wave. So the steeper the takeoff is, the more you have to be leaning on your nose. That's why it's really hard to catch a big steep wave on a foil, because basically you have to have your nose pointed straight down. So in that case, what I usually do is I try to go for the shoulder, try to get away from that steep part of the wave if possible and ride it along the shoulder. Because once you get that angle of attack too steep, the foil just breaches and you crash. Following the contour of the wave is real important to keep that angle of attack in a smaller range. And Sam always says, ride low and in control. So that means just keeping the foil underwater. Don't come up too high. You don't get the foil too close to the surface. Keep that angle of attack fairly low so you don't create too much lift too quickly where the foil shoots out of the water and just breaches. And that's probably one of the hardest things to learn at first, is keeping the foil in the water, keeping the board in control, and keeping it low to the water. Come up slowly and then keep it there. Hope that helped. Thanks for watching. Aloha.